more nodes? No, I don't. Crap.
Shuffle yourself. Patient. Symptoms.
Oh dear, it's right next to me. Well, whatever I hit must have killed it completely. Sort of explosive. I thought I heard it around here somewhere, but... the time for a save? Come on. Don't mess with me, I have an explosive nutsack. The marker. Great, there goes my explosive sack. Viscerator trophy earned. Oh. Oh, I remember this from the first game. Yep. Exactly as I remembered. Oh, there's another. the whole visual setting I saw from it way back when speaks for itself. First officer. Oh, list of everyone who's a unitologist on this ship. Oh, this is what he gets out of this, by the looks of it.
Cluster behind you.
Not yet. Not, if, escape on that shuttle and you'll kill us all. When they took the marker from Aegis 7, it woke the being at the core of the planet.
Divine mind.
The hell is that?
Mercer calls it the Hive Mind. Nexus organs which controls these necromorphs to our path. If we leave while the Hive Mind is active, well, you saw Valor. If even a single necromorph escapes, humanity is finished. The marker. Amelia, she told me it would return the beast to its number.
Okay. So if we return the marker to Aegis 7, it'll stop the outbreak?
Exactly. But we need the shuttle to return it to the planet. You have a singularity core. And I can retrieve it. So what do you say?
If it'll end this for good, deal.
Excellent. I can distract Mercer, but not for long. But get the marker to the shuttle bay quickly. Thank you, Mr. Reed, for helping me fix my mistakes.
No problem. Some severance to the marker and hide my eyes coordinate. Can I mind slip the markers and put it somehow? But if the series correct, the two are at odds. If the marker can call a hive, my eye would cut the puppeteer's streaks at a stroke. Seems obvious. In most respect, these necromorphs have no intelligence. How could they? Yet there's clear, if rudimentary purpose behind their actions, especially if they gather. Especially gathering corpses, they're clearly following some drive to kill organisms and gather biomass. Where does that drive come from? How does it command them? Do all necromorphs can. Whereby a marker share this bond? Back in seniors, the Hive Mind demonstrating a genuine telepathic communication, perhaps the first ever observed. How painful to admit that the marker's core still holds fascination to me. Now I think I understand my predecessors, those who first studied the black marker rather better. The road to hell begins with unprincipled curiosity. Foolish, I should have known sabotaging the engines was only a stopgap, so he did it. I return to Earth. Is the marker falling back into the Church's hands? Is it many others? Always alternate solutions, always. Now to retrieve the marker. Right behind me. It's glowing. Everything's glowing. Well, there's my explosive nutsack. Okay. To it, it's like screen distorts. That's a good detail. I gotta test the shuttle's engines, then the fight begins. Dr. Kai come in? What? Really? Here?
You bastard! Take it. Bring convergence! Make us whole!
Thank you.
So I guess that's the third and final tentacle.
Do you read me? Mr. Clark! Mr. Clark, come in!
Fuck this ship.
You're alive. Altman beat me.
Fuck Altman too. Kendra?
Yeah. But every alert on the Ishimura is screaming. Critical damage to internal systems. The marker just ripped right through the ship. Something pulled it down to the cargo bay.
Pilot the shuttle to the hangar. Going after the marker.
Of course. Amelia, quickly.
Wait, Dr. Kine. That guy's lost it. He killed the captain. We can't trust him near the marker.
He says returning it to the planet is the only way to end this. We've got to try. I'm heading to cargo. You ping Nicole's rig and tell her where to go.
Leave it to me.
Thanks. When I get the marker, we're all getting out of here.
Can't forget Dr. Cross, keeper of the faith. Load the marker. And now we are in chapter 11. Alternate solutions. And then the last chapter is called Dead Space. And with that, a secret message within the first letters of each level will be revealed. We all know what it is. Cryogenics? How did I get back here? Well, I got front row seats to that. The hunter death, I mean. Kinda miss its all iconic scream at the end of that. Going, something like that. Chemical lab. Okay, now that I'm here. Oh, I chopped him up just right there and then. Oh, wait, what hit me? Oh.
Critical systems fast.
All right. Back where I started, kinda. All right. guys, I'm gonna leave it here for tonight. I hope y'all enjoyed. I think tomorrow we will have officially finished this game. We're looking forward to that. Yes, these past few chapters have actually been pretty fun. I mean, chapter 10 was one of my favorites, and being able to end the hunter, they definitely made it more interesting by making you seek out and destroy the tendrils blocking off the marker and having to ship it yourself. More or less things remain the same, and of course the hunter seemed more of a stalker in that level. Kinda wish they made it like Mr. X in a sense, where it was almost always stalking you. I just had a few more appearances. It felt like it was more present in the first game, but I could be wrong. I mean, they seemed to give it an extra encounter in Chapter 7, and yeah, it seemed to be around a bit more, this level. Chapter 5, when it first debuted, it just seemed like that one intermission hall, and when we first met it, and the cryogenics, and that was it. Here we were, it's chasing us throughout the different sections of the crew deck. So yeah, guys, I'm gonna leave it here. I hope you all enjoy, and I shall see you in the next one. Peace.